that the CR17 documents are of public interest and will approach the Constitutional Court directly to ensure that these documents are unsealed. Someone came to me, fellow fighters, during the week and said, our deputy president is in the CR17 documents. We want to say to them, one, that our deputy president is not in the CR17 documents. But as a matter of principle, whether he's there or not, we want those documents unsealed. And our deputy president himself wants those documents unsealed. When I was doubtful of appealing this matter to the Constitutional Court and thought, you know, it's a waste of time, like it appears in many other arrangements, that there's an impression created that certain people win in court and certain people don't win in court. So I was saying, let's not appeal this matter, let's leave it, because it looks like it will be the same thing. It is the deputy president of the EFF who led the charge and demanded that this matter must be taken to the Constitutional Court. Majority of the officials of the EFF and leaders of the EFF have insisted that this matter must go to the Constitutional Court. And with the guidance provided by the deputy president and the collective, we are taking this matter to the Constitutional Court. Although we suspect what could be the possible outcome given the current arrangement, we are prepared to die with our boots on. We never retreat on a battlefield. We fight a battle to its logical conclusion, and we'll fight this one to its logical conclusion. We do not care.